Bring us to this moment, to the threshold of your word. Allow us to enter into your word, that we might not only hear your word, but see your word. We thank you, God, for the series that you have begun on today. We ask that you be blessed, that we will be empowered by your word, that we be stronger, that we be better, that we be greater servants unto you and unto one another. Please don't bless us, we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. We're starting this morning a four-part series called The Power of a Strong Family. Amen. The first part will be, we'll start with the woman on today. Then on next week, we'll go to the man. And then on the third week, we'll go to the children. And then we'll conclude with looking at ourselves and what kind of family members are we. So today, if you would go with me to the book of Genesis, chapter 2. Amen. Genesis chapter 2, let's begin at the 21st verse. God said, it is not good that the man should be alone.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now, he already had animals. Mm-hmm. And we know that the dog is only ordained the woman to be with the man. It is not good that a man should be alone. Two more structures in the human body.
Wow.
The first is the skull, which protects the fragile brain or your mind.
Amen.
The second is the rib cage,
all right,
which encases the heart and the lungs.
Yeah.
Obviously, either of them stop working or are excessively damaged, your heart, your brain, or your heart or your lungs, you're going to die. To protect them, God designed an encasing that consists of the strongest bones and layers of tissue we have. So this woman would not only be part of the man, but she would be the possessor, the one who holds, the possessor of his heart, and the one within whom he breathes, in whom his spirit is given a place to abide. She would encapsulate his spirit in the same way that the church, when two or three are gathered, plays host to the Holy Spirit, where therein indwells, and thus she was to be loved by this man, as God loved his church.
Amen.
Finally, she is called woman, or womb of man, not rib of man. And the womb is the source of life.
Yeah.
And so she would be the source of his life and his sustenance.
Well, yeah.
But we seem to have taken a wrong turn with the way men and women treat each other.
Yeah.
There seems to be this new age stuff from a lot of the young people that the woman is no longer to be respected, but disrespected.
Wow.
We dance to the rap lyrics that insult our women.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
That put them down to the level of a female dog. We celebrate that, amen? But one thing I did with my three sons, I made sure that they understood,
amen,
what a woman is, what a woman means,
yes,
and the very gift that a woman is.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
Because I tell you, you can tell a whole lot about a man by the way he treats his mom.
Amen.
Next to God, would be no one so important, so close, so knowing of the man and his needs and his aspirations and his feelings, and so able to give all of that life and vitality and help in bringing the man's dreams and visions to a reality. Can I get a witness? I know a lot of the New Age stuff don't think like that no more. We don't teach that a woman ought to submit to a man. Come on, somebody. And can I just throw this one in there? Ladies, you got to be smart enough to know the type of man to submit to. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Reason why a lot of you are crying tears of hurt and pain and heartache, come on somebody, because you have submitted to the wrong man. You follow him as he follows Christ. So no man can disrespect or diminish the status of a woman or women in general, and not be obedient to God.
Amen.
More importantly, a man cannot disrespect a woman and expect his heart and spirit and a rebirth to be complete.
Amen.
Finally, no woman should ever diminish herself and her right to respect For she alone is given the gift of bringing forth life.
Right.
As did God himself. And of playing this vital role. The reason why I could never think about disrespecting my mom. Because she carried me.
Amen.
In her womb.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
For 9 months.
Amen.
And she's the only mother that God gave me.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. No matter what she is or was, she's still my mother.
Amen.
And I could not fathom, amen, talking about lifting up a hand to strike her or to disrespect her. Can I get a witness? And that's one way that I'll take my kids out. I brought them in this world. I'll take them out if they ever lift a hand toward their mom. Because it is to me that we just going to have to deal with that. Come on, somebody. Man, we have to check our sons sometimes. You may get to the point where you got to pull them off to the side of the road and stand toe to toe with them. Come on, can I get a witness? We must. Yes, amen. Say that again, baby. I do that with my son Gregg Jr. He had gotten tall, and we riding in the truck one afternoon, and he just got the truck bad. I pulled the truck over. I said, "Get off my truck, Dad! What are you talking about? Get out my truck!" Amen. And we was on the sidewalk. I said, "What you feeling?" What you feeling, son? What it is, son? What you feeling, man? What you feeling? Dad, yeah, your dad.
Yeah.
I would have boxed him up. Because if I don't box him up, the correctional officer, the parole officer, the judge will, the police officer will. But we talk about the rent. So many men suffer today from rib deficiency syndrome. And they either have none, nor know that if they do, she is to be situated closest to his heart and spirit. But just as the rib is vital to the man, there are different kinds of rib. As we ask the question this morning, what kind of rib are you? I want to look at primarily four kinds of rib. First, we have the spare rib. He is okay with being the side chick. Feels okay with being the mistress. She's a homewrecker. She has no self-respect.
Amen.
And she's okay with being the spirit. She doesn't mind being known as the other woman. She specializes in booty calls. Never take the spare rib home to mom.
Amen.
Because the spare rib has to be a secret. Secret lovers. Me and Mrs. Jones. We got a thing going on. If loving you is right, I don't want to be one. We meet at the same cafe. Can I get a witness? I'll be loving, go home to my wife's bed. Come on, somebody. I'll take a disease from her and bring that disease right home, amen, because she is a spare rib. Like $1 million. And the kids look like a dime. Come on, somebody. She will get her nails done, her hair done, before she gets anything right for the kids. Can I get a witness? She will cuss the kids out in public because she's immature. She is childish. She could also be a gold digger. Amen. If you run into the right baby back rib, you might be able to have her for a McDonald's Happy Meal. She's childish. She doesn't know her value. She's a baby back rib. She can't cook, won't clean. Her hair and nails are more important than the kids. She's still a baby. She's a baby having a baby. She's still a baby in her mind, in her thinking, in her attitudes, and in her choices. She might have a grown woman's body, but she's got a baby back mind. She's not Ruth, she's ruthless. She's vindictive. And she's alive. Most men end up ruining their happy home for a baby back rib.
What you say?
Come on, can I get a little bit? Because see, we men, we go through this thing called midlife crisis, where we get a little less hair in the back, and come on, somebody. And come on, can I get a witness? And we go to the doctor to try to get a Viagra prescription, amen? And we may buy a motorcycle or a sports car so that we can feel our youth. Come on, can I get a witness? And then we will go crazy when a baby back rib gives us some sort of attention. But she don't know how to be a helpmate. Can I get a witness? And anybody that's old enough to be your daughter, you ought to check yourself. See, a grown man shouldn't be caught with a baby back rib. And she might be jailbait. What kind of rib are you? Then, for the belly, there's the country-style rib. Anybody know what a country-style rib is?
Yes.
A country-style rib is old-fashioned.
Old-fashioned.
She was taught how to cook.
Yeah. Watch out now.
She know how to clean. She know how to cuddle. Can I get a window? She know old-fashioned. She know how to fix stuff. Can I get a window? She ain't worried about knee press on nails when she can't fix stuff, amen. Because she don't worry about nails and all that stuff. Can I get a window? She's a country-style rib. She knows how to not only fix stuff, but she knows how to stretch a dollar. A country-style rib might have a pocketbook full of, come on, can I get a window? Coupon. You know how to stretch that dollar. Now we ain't eating at McDonald's, amen. Because public got to get the stuff on sale. Let's go in there and get this, amen. Because we gotta take care of this stuff.
That's right. Yes.
She's not streetwise. She's not that hip.
No.
Some may even call her green. Amen? Because she hasn't been shamed by all of that stuff. Can I get a witness? She's always risen above that stuff. Amen? She might not be the prettiest. But for those of you who are still caught, amen, on baby back friends, you can appreciate a country style rib because you don't know what you have. And watch this. More men are more intimidated by a country style rib. That's why all they do is get baby back ribs. If you're a real man, you know how to deal with a country style rib.
You gotta preach, I say. Preach, I say.
Her heart, she wears a heart on her sleeve.
Yes.
Sometimes you just may see her crying about the situation. Late in the midnight, she'll be up because she loves, and she loves hard, and she loves true. Can I get a witness? And the reason why she has gone through a lot of the heartaches that she has gone through is because she's trustworthy. She don't know how to deal with a city slicker, amen? She may believe anything you might tell her because she's true and she's genuine. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
But because of that, she has a lot of pain and heartache And you, anybody here ever been hurt, amen, because of the love that you gave? That you trust the wrong man? He promised you the sky and you believed it, amen, and he was a no good rascal?
Yes. Preaching that.
Sometimes she lets herself go because she has more important priorities.
Yes.
She puts the children before the hairstylist.
Yes.
She will make sure that the children have what they need.
Yes.
And she will go without. Because that's the sort of woman that she is.
Yes.
She doesn't spend a whole lot on herself.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
You might not ever know that she doesn't spend a lot on herself. But she takes care of her priorities.
Mm-hmm.
She makes sure that her man has everything that he needs. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
She'll fix his plate before she fixes her plate.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
And she knows how to take two potatoes and a little bit of meat and some vegetables and make a stew that you could eat all week long. Help me tell you those, amen. She knows how to sew clothes, amen. She'll make sure the kids have their hand-me-downs instead of wasting all our money. Can I get a witness? She don't waste money for the kids on Nikes and $200 shoes. She makes sure that the kids have everything that they need. She goes to the PTA meeting. Can I get a witness? And she knows how to discipline her kids. Because she knows if she's spared a rod, she'll spoil the child. And another thing about the country style here. Don't take her kindness for weakness.
Please not.
Don't cut, don't cross. Can I get a witness? It might take her a long time to get to the point where she's done with you. You might have taken her through a whole lot, but when she gets to that point, she's done. And ain't no crying, ain't no begging, ain't no shouting, amen, gonna get her back. She loved you and you should appreciate it while you had it. St. Louis Street. Now, St. Louis is not L.A., the hip scene of Hollywood, and it ain't New York. It ain't the hip scene in New York, amen, because Hollywood is nothing but a lot of glitter, and New York is nothing but a lot of phony, fake people. Can I get a witness? She's somewhere in the heartland. She's in the Bible Belt. Can I get a witness? She's from St. Louis in her spirit. Can I get a witness? See, y'all love them them L.A. women, amen, with all that broad hair. Can I get a witness? With all that broad nails. Can I get a witness? With all that broad stuff. Help me, Holy Ghost. Y'all like the New York women, amen, with all them fancy weeds and all that crazy stuff, dressing like Beyonce. Can I get a witness? But the St. Louis real, amen. She ain't that. She is neutral.
Yes.
And she has natural beauty. Too much respect. You got to earn the cookie.
That's right.
Help me, Holy Ghost.
Yes.
She's a prime rib. Because she knows her worth.
That's right.
She knows her price is far above rubies.
That's right.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
She knows. Now, she might not have always been a prime rib woman.
Right.
Maybe she had to go through some of these other
That's
types,
right.
amen, to get to prime rib. Maybe she had to be hurt, torn down, tossed, and turned out, amen. But now, since she got God in her life, can I get a witness? She don't dress the same way, she don't act the same way, she don't talk the same way, and you ain't getting the same way with her. Can I get a witness? Amen. As a matter of fact, to get to her heart, you got to go through the law. Because she's covered with Jesus.
Yes.
The Proverbs 31 woman is a prime rib. The Bible says she's up before dawn. She fixes lunches and drives the kids to school. She takes them to the games. She sits in traffic while making phone calls to maybe about her job. She's setting up meetings. She gives all that she's got in her 9-to-5. She collects the kids while still answering emails. She helps with their homework, makes it to midweek Bible study, cooks balanced meals for the family. And at the end of the day, she spends time with her husband. Yeah. All that in the span of 24 hours. Can I get a witness? Now, if you don't get up to 2 o'clock in the afternoon, kids got to fend for themselves in the morning. They got to dress themselves this morning. It don't matter whether they wash up or whatever. They just going out to go to school, amen. So you can turn on the TV and watch the soap operas.
Nah, Lord.
You're not a prime rib. What kind of rib are you? A prime rib, she's a mother. She is a woman. She is a rib. Which is why I cringe at the misconception that Christian women are weak. Weakness will comprise our families and husbands. The world needs strong, godly women.
Yes.
I'm not talking about manipulative, win at all cost type strength. I'm talking about a strength that knows that when there's something that's needed in the house, know how to get down on her knees.
Yes.
Know how to take it to the Lord.
Yes.
Know how to get a prayer through.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
I've learned a strong word that comes about through grace.
Yes.
But don't mistake a strong Christian woman for a doormat.
That's right. That's right.
She's got grace. And you got to be careful how you treat a praying woman.
Amen.
Ooh, say that. Say it.
Amen.
Amen.
She's not strong because of her inner ability or will. She's strong in God's grace.
Right.
In his supernatural power. And she knows how to connect to it. Don't make her cry tears of heartache and pain too long. Don't do it. Don't play with a prime rib woman. You might not be ready for prime time.
Amen.
But if you're still a boy, you won't be able to handle a prime rib woman.
That's right.
So don't even try to look for one. Amen. You got to be spiritually ready to handle a prime rib woman.
Yes.
Biblical women were not weak. Do you think Esther or Deborah or Lydia or Mary or Martha or Priscilla were weak? They were women who defied the odds.
Amen.
rescue their nation, and change the world with strong prime ribs. Then there's that Proverbs 31 woman.
Jesus.
The lady that all of women of God should aspire to be like. The Proverbs 31 rib was strong in all the right places. And she gives us a blueprint on how to live with strength and honor.
Yeah.
If we break down Proverbs 31, we see six qualities that will make you a prime rib. So if you want to be a prime rib, you're tired of being a baby back, you're going to rib, start taking notes. A prime rib, the first characteristic, is trustworthy.
That's right. That's right.
A good, supportive, trusting rib is a blessing to a man.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Well, come on, brothers. It's hard when we can't trust a woman.
Amen.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
A woman who partners with her husband, who is reliable and looks out for his interests. She gives a man a security that is greatly lacking in the world. The last thing a hardworking man wants to do when he come home is come home to what? Come on, y'all finish that for me. What type of woman a man does not want to come home to?
Nagging.
Y'all said it, I didn't.
I said it.
A prime rib is not only trustworthy, but she's energetic. She isn't afraid of work.
Yeah, that's right.
She gets up in the morning and get things done. In the time of Solomon, this involved making fabric, sewing clothes. But verse 27 of Proverbs 31 certainly applies directly to us today. A woman is energetic, a prime rib, she takes care of her responsibilities. And she has a lot of wisdom. One thing that the devil makes a mistake with, brothers, with us, is that we don't always listen to the wisdom of the woman that God sends to us. We think she's being insecure when she tells you, be careful about them women over there. Because a woman knows another.
That's right.
Come on, can I get a witness?
Yeah.
Be careful of that, baby. I ain't trying to be insecure, amen. I know you mind, but you need to be careful.
Right.
Because that woman sitting back there, amen, that'd be all smiling in your face all the time. Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
She's in debt. But also, prime rib demonstrates service to others. Another characteristic of wisdom is the grace to help others. My mama used to say, have kids from the neighborhood sometimes come over and eat. If they were playing in my room and it was dinner time,
that's right.
Come on, sit at the table. Another mother didn't mind. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Because that's how we just had really a whole lot of mothers. And wherever you was, if you was hungry, she'd feed you. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
She'd make sure she would take a little. I still don't know how my mama did it. We getting all kind of money now. And can't have food on the cupboard. And I know my mama, when my daddy left, my mama had minimal. She was a country style woman. But when he left, she had to become a prime rib. She took training and she went and got a job. Because when my daddy was with her, she was a stay-at-home mom. Her career was raising the kids.
Right.
And my sister will tell you, we never went without anything.
That's right.
And dressed good on Sunday.
Right.
On welfare.
Yeah.
Until my mama said, we just gonna be on this for a little while. We need this right now. But I'm going to get trained. Next thing I know, she started going to Macy's. got a job there. She finished and she retired there at Macy's. She used to get on that train in New York and go to the city. Mama, I see my mama transition. She changed.
Yes.
When my daddy left, my sister will tell you, my mama weighed nearly 400 pounds.
Yes.
She started going to Weight Watchers.
Yes.
Yes. Can I get a witness?
Yes.
Next day I know some of the deacons in the church started looking at
her.
She reinvented herself.
Yes.
And we never went without. See, that service to others, a prime rib, also number four, knows her worth.
Yeah.
She's educated about the world and the world of business. She knows how to use her skills to provide for her family.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
She's not afraid to go interact with that world, whether it be as a merchant or a buyer.
Mm-hmm.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
And so I just watch my mom she started doing air in the kitchen. Come on, somebody. We had dryers in the kitchen. Come on, somebody. She sold dinners. Me and my sister, we had the running kind of dinners all over the projects. Can I get a witness? Because Laura May was cooking dinners. She used to even have a rent party. When the rent was behind, can I get a witness? All my uncles and everybody came over. We had a little phonograph where there's a little disc on the 45s, and he had all his records stacked up. Can I get a witness? And they started dancing, and the kids used to be back there in the back room. We supposed to be looking at TV. Amen. But when my song came on, the kids and my cousin and we in the back room just dancing too. Can I get a witness? We were just dancing because my mother knew how to take care of business. I don't know, I'm just bringing all kinds of memories back to my sister. I'm telling you, our childhood was special. That's why I love my mama so today. Because I know what she did for us. And all of us went to college.
Amen.
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 She knows how to use her strength to her best advantage. And she fully realizes how valuable her efforts are. Proverbs 31, rib, not only knows her worth, but she knows her responsibilities to herself. She would not be able to provide for others if she neglected her needs, both physical and spiritual. She makes her appearance reflect her respected position as an influence in her community. Her greatest strength is her wisdom, her accurate judgment about the world, and her influence in it. And she's quick to share the wisdom she has gained to encourage others to reach their full potential. She is not intimidated by another woman.
Yes.
Because she knows her worth. Can I get a word? When she walks into a room, it seems like the whole room gets quiet. Can I get a witness? It gets quiet because it gets reflected. Amen. But if a hoochie coochie walk into the room, it gets loud. You hear whistles and ooh, baby. But when a strong red, prime red walks into the room, the men get reflected. Because you will attract the type of fish according to the bait that you use. All of that flesh to catch him? You have to use that flesh to keep him. And all he want is flesh. Can I get a witness? Five, a prime rib is a minister. She knows that as a partner in her marriage, she has a tremendous influence on her husband's ministry. The reason why the Proverbs 31 Rib's husband was able to praise her in the gates because she was well respected. She carried herself well, not only in his company, but outside of his company. Because she knew she represented him. Can I get a witness? She knows how to put you in check too. Brothers, if you try to disrespect her behind her man's back, she will put you in check right then and there.
Yes, sir.
Amen? She don't play with that. She can integrate her life, both domestic and professional, with her ministry in such a way that her husband has the freedom to serve the Lord.
Yeah.
It, I'm trying to help a prime rib today, right now. Don't get more out of control dealing with people than your husband allows you to. What did I mean? Don't, if you see some, let me put it this way. If you see somebody mistreating that husband of yours, amen? Because of the position he has in God, you don't have to fight and argue and curse that person out. Can I get a witness? You carry yourself like the woman that you are. All you gotta do is stand with your man. You ain't gotta get out there taking on earrings and ass off, kicking on shoes. Amen. Can I get a witness? Put Vaseline all in your face. You ain't gotta go to battle like that. Amen. You can say, baby, we're gonna pray. Amen. Because the devil is a liar. You embarrass him. Amen. When you out there fighting out of the street, even to protect his honor. Stand with him.
Yes, that's right. Amen.
Did y'all get
that
one? It's hard for a man to be in ministry if his wife has a reputation as a troublemaker, a gossiper. Come on, can I get a witness? It affects his ministry.
Yes, that's right.
I know a preacher who used to be married, and his wife was alcoholic. Come to church. Well, we're going to buzz. Sometimes more than buzz. She was hard, and what she, the way she lived affected his ministry. She should have stayed on top of her reputation, her character, her image. Amen?
Yeah.
Because what happens with her directly affects him.
Yes.
And we already battle in the world, especially as black men.
Mm-hmm.
We already got a fight.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
Mm-hmm.
Just because of the color of our skin and the fact that we're a black man in America.
Yes.
We need, amen, a queen.
Yeah.
A prime rib is a queen. Somebody who goes through and elevate and deals with the world with us.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Amen.
Finally, she is a prime rib is virtuous. Her children stand and bless them.
Yeah.
Amen? I'm telling you, y'all, it reflects on the mother when the child, when the mother takes that child out around other people, and that child embarrasses them. Act like they ain't got no training. Can I get a witness? But when you got a prime rib out of the mother, kids just be sitting up straight, amen. You got the mother kid, they be walking all on the chairs in the restaurant, amen, throwing food at the waitress. And when the mama tell them, you see this, when the mama tell them to stop, they'll raise their hand and try to hit their mama. Come on, somebody. I was standing online at the bank one day. This little boy was just named Tommy. He was terrible. Look, his mother was so stressed. Can I get a witness? He must have been 2 years old. And she was so stressed. She said, Tommy, please. He was just all over. And then he was just like trying to kick people and stuff. And then he came up to me.
I wish you would.
See, a woman can only take a male child but so far.
That's right.
He need daddy to come around.
Amen.
Just daddy's voice alone is enough to do it. Can I get a witness? And in my household, amen, if you disrespect my mom, get the word out. Just daddy's calling. She said, yeah, I'm going to call out. I'm talking on the phone. Yeah, he did this. He was talking like this. I heard my father say, I'll be right there. You hear the car pulling up. You hear this keys coming in the door. You are petrified. Kids don't have that nowadays.
They don't.
For the most part. Can I get a witness? Women are raising boys, and it's not meant to be that way.
That's right.
But you're doing the best you can, and I'm so glad that you are, amen. But the head, God has made the head, the man is supposed to be the head of his table. And that's why I'm saying Satan is attacking the family. Because if he can remove the man from the head of the family, amen, and make the woman get outside of her role and do a thing that God never ordained for her to do, then the kids will be messed up, and they'll end up raising themselves. And that's what you have outdoors now, kids raising
themselves.
And I'm telling you, it starts when they're 2 and 3. You got to put the rod on them, amen, when they are that age. You spare it, you spoil it. She's virtuous. She does not need to push or throw her weight around. She does not rely on charm to get her way. She is kind, considerate. She is a strong Christian woman. She is capable. She is confident in her own abilities. She doesn't have to put another woman down in order for herself to look good.
Yes.
You, prime rib, are deserving of praise and adoration. Your husband and children know the gift they have in you. They are blessed by your strength. The world needs strong women. Your husband needs a strong rib. Your children need a strong mother. So be one. What kind of rib are you? Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. When women become the prime rib that God ordained for them to be, the world will be a much stronger place. When women take their role alongside their king, the world will be a much stronger place. Your ministry will be stronger. This church will be stronger. Can I get a witness? We need mothers who are seasoned, who understand what a prime rib is. And they are teaching the younger women how to be prime ribs.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen?
Because I don't know about nobody else in here, but I want a prime cut.
Yeah.
I don't want a slave. Amen?
Amen.
I want to help me.
Yeah.
Look, turn to the person next to you and say, what kind of rib?
What kind of rib?
Are you? Can I get a witness? that king, you start praying for him even before the Lord sent him. Because you know he's somewhere out there. Can I get a witness? And don't settle. Don't settle. You know, sometimes we settle. Well, why do people say, oh, having some man is better than having no man? That ain't true, man. Amen? When your standards are where they're supposed to be, got strong standards. We're intimidated by that. We'd rather come easy, amen. Make him work for it. Make him earn it. Make him respect it. That's what God is calling for now. So now we just started with the women today. We're for part two. Come back for part two. We're going to talk about the man next week. So come on, brother.